is to be here tonight. If I had the ability, I would love for each one of you to walk just in my shoes and feel all of it tonight, to feel the passion, to feel the strength, to feel the energy in this room, and to feel the possibility in this room when we all come together at such a difficult time. There's really only one place to begin tonight. We've had, of course, to take the time just a few moments to thank everybody that took part in what was a 3.5-month-long, very difficult at times, a very long process. The Central Labor Council's executive board participated with this, and I know that their time is so precious. They're out there, they're fighting hard and working for you, and they took the time out of their schedules to make sure that this process was done with the greatest level of participation. And I really can't say enough to have received the support of them and how grateful I am to each one of them for putting forth the effort that they did to make tonight possible. The National AFL-CIO, Dave Kiker, and the whole entire staff, I want you to please thank all seven of Dave and the entire staff. Governance Department at the AFL-CIO was the Leadership Institute, and I had the privilege back a few years ago to go to the Leadership Institute of the National AFL-CIO, and David was one of the instructors, so we can use this, I guess, as a platform for future conventions and meetings and issues and things to discuss at the Leadership Institute. The entire staff of the Central Labor Council and the state AFL-CIO has worked so hard and so tirelessly. I really can't say enough about each of them. Bradley Griffith and Sean Macklin, the entire staff of the CLC and Manantis Daily. Mario Salento has, I think Mario will finally be able to get some sleep tonight. He has been working tirelessly at this for several weeks now to make sure that we did it properly, it was inclusive, in accordance with all the rules and regulations of the guidelines that the National AFL-CIO has us follow, and he did a phenomenal job. And of course, Dennis Hughes, I can't say enough about the leadership of Dennis Hughes. I want to be the state credit for the past 7 months, and it's been a privilege. It's been a privilege to work with a professional staff of competent individuals, and it's been a real education to work and watch Dennis at work day in and day out, fighting for each of you. So I thank you, Dennis, for all of it. In addition, as they mentioned, I'm a member of Local 3 of the IBEW for 21 years, and I can't say enough about the leadership, about the professionalism of that unit. You know, with Chris Erickson, who's here tonight, the business manager, President John Marshall, and the other offices and members of Local 3, can't thank you enough for all the years to provide the level of exceptional leadership in that union and here in this city, and really can beacon for everybody throughout this country. So I thank each of you. Our city our state, and our country are going through an incredibly difficult time. Going through one of the most difficult economic periods of the past 8 years. And during that time, we know we've seen workers suffer dramatically. Today, we see workers in every sector. We see workers in public sector, in private sector, in building trades facing unacceptable levels of unemployment, attacks on their pension, attacks on their health care and health benefits, declining or stagnant wages, the loss of jobs, assaults on collective bargaining rights, and levels of income disparity that we have not seen since the days of the 1920s. But we all know that this trend, it didn't happen overnight. It happened and really began several decades ago, and the struggles, they continue today for each one of us. So tonight, we begin anew, together, as one labor movement, in the spirit of unity, in the spirit of dedication, to the common belief that workers are entitled to certain things, basic fundamental rights, dignity at work, respect at work, a fair and a level playing field at work.
And there's unorganized
They're not even sure when they get to work at the end of the week if there's going to be a paycheck their way. And they too are counting on us to get it right. You see, we've got to believe in the principles that we fight for, the principles that we stand for every day. And we have to remember that we are here to serve and not be served. Let's get to it.